the input strip. In this video, we'll give you an overview of the X32's channel strip. Every channel on the X32 shares the same channel strip. Select the input or auxiliary channel you wish to modify, and the channel strip now applies your changes to that channel. X32's flexible routing lets you assign any input to any channel. By selecting channel 1 here, all of the parameters on the top left section of the X32 now apply to this channel. The preamp section of the channel strip controls the Midas designed mic preamps. This is where you adjust the gain, activate 48 volt phantom power for condenser mics and active DIs, or switch the phase. Next to this, we have a low cut, high pass filter for eliminating unwanted lows or electrical hums. X32's dynamics section includes both a gate and a compressor limiter. In the gate section, you can set the threshold, turn the gate on or off, as well as monitor gate activity. The same indicator is always shown above the channel fader. Press the view button to bring up additional controls for attack, release, and hold on the high-res LCD screen. The dynamics section also controls the compressor limiter. You have a choice between compression and expansion. This is great for extremely dynamic sounds like kick and snare drums, or a vocalist with a wide dynamic range. Use the threshold knob to set the level where the compression kicks in. The compression LED will light up when the compressor grabs the signal. This also shows on the input meter above the faders on every channel. Select View to bring up a visual of the compressor and all related parameters on the main screen. Now let's take a look at the EQ section. Here we find four bands of fully parametric EQ. The frequencies are divided into high, high mid, low mid, and low. Each band can be further set to the following settings: high cut, high shelf, vintage style Q as found in vintage British consoles, parametric EQ, low shelf EQ, and low cut EQ. Select the frequency that you'd like to zero in on, the gain level, and the Q or width of selected frequency. Press the View button for a visual view of your EQ options on the main screen. The next section houses controls for the 16 bus sends and features four rotary encoders in four layers. Select View to adjust settings for pre or post fader and more on the main screen. Finally, we have the pan encoder, on-off switch to send to the master stereo bus, and a mono send level to feed a mono bus. The mono bus is helpful for sending specific channels like kick drum and bass guitar to subwoofers. This has been the input strip video for the X32 digital mixer from Behringer. To learn more, check out www.behringer.com.